to keep your heart in tune.
Thank you, Lord.
So right now we're going to go and open up a little space for our praise. Because we know that someone have a praise.
Amen.
We know that someone in the building, brethren, know something about what the Lord has
yeah.
done. Brethren, you know what the Lord has done. Won't you open up your hearts right now and give God a praise. Brethren, as you sing this song, praise the Lord, everybody.
Thank you.
he did. Yeah. Then they'll turn around and say, I'm so glad that he did. Yeah. Then they'll turn around and say, he woke me up this morning. Yeah. Started me on my way. Yeah. Hey, I know we got one another one, Billy. And how many thought about that? I've been dancing a long time. I just been trying to get a little sweat. Praise the Lord. I just been trying to get a little sweat. Praise the Lord. Right in front of your feet. Praise. I want to give you a big one in front of y'all about 5 seconds.
service. Oh, happy day. Amen. We thank God. Amen. You may be seated. Amen. All over the heavens on this morning. Amen. We count it indeed a blessing to be in the house of the Lord. We give God thanks for all visitors, saints, and friends being with us on today. For this is the day that the Lord has made. As we sing, we rejoice, and our souls are being made glad. Glad in it. The psalmist David said, oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. It was the same David that said that I was young, and now I am old. I've never seen the righteous forsaken nor his seed begging bread. Amen. We give God thanks for this Independence Day. Amen. A day of freedom. A day where people do pretty much what they have desired to do. And that is to be off from work. Come on. Can't get no help.
That's right.
It's free in the day. Yeah. Free to drink another cup of that coffee. Come on. Huh? Amen. But in July 4, 1776, amen, the United States of America was granted freedom. And we see that the people are running all over the world.
That's right.
Come on. Amen. Ain't that right? Amen. But it's now time for God's people. Y'all ain't hear me? To be free.
That's right.
Be free. On today, amen, all preachers, ministers, wives, amen, in your respective places all over the world. We thank God, amen, for you. Amen. We thank God, again, for the one plan of salvation. Because there is but one plan.
That's right.
One plan for all nationality. Come on.
Amen. That's right.
Every creed, every color, come on. Every man that ever walked in shoes,
left. That's right.
There's but one plan of salvation.
Yes, right.
There's one thing. Come on. That can see us from our sins.
Yeah.
That is Jesus Christ. Right. And it is the Son of the living God. The Bible tells us in him we live, and in him we move, and in him we have our being.
Right.
We're living in the last days. We're living in a time where people are hating one another.
Oh, yeah.
The black is against the black. The black is against the white. The white is against the white. And the white is against the black.
Well, that's right.
Come on.
Yeah, right.
Everybody is against somebody.
Oh, yeah.
But God is love.
That's right.
Come on.
That's right.
For without God, we can do nothing.
Amen.
The just shall live by faith.
Amen.
And if any draw back, the Bible declares that God himself will have no pleasure in us.
That's right.
But the Bible says we are his people and the sheep of his pastors. Amen. We are to enter into his courts with thanksgiving and in conjunction with praise. We are to be thankful unto the Lord and bless his name, for he is good.
Amen.
His mercy is everlasting.
That's right.
And his truth, come on, endure to all generations.
Amen.
We're living in a COVID season. A season where we have to mask, amen, where we have to wash our hands, where we have to social distance ourselves.
That's right.
Huh? But the Bible tells us that after this life is over, we've got another home. Come on. Amen. And hopefully this home is in heaven.
Amen.
Amen. That's right.
Hmm? Unfortunately, there's two plagues. Come on.
But that's right.
That's right. That's right.
I say, somebody say, why you say unfortunate? Because you have to make up your mind which home you going.
But that's right.
Yeah. Somebody say, I got no heaven, no hell to put nobody in. And that's true. But Jesus, come on, the God of God,
amen,
the Lord of Lords.
That's right.
Huh? He's the just judge.
Oh, yeah.
He's the one that will separate sheep from goats.
That's right.
And goats from sheep.
Amen.
He is the one, come on, that will say, depart from me.
Amen.
Or the one that will say, come on in.
Oh, yeah.
Come on in. So if I do like my Lord say do, I know that everything will be all right. May you pray with me.
Right.
And then we pray that when these live events are over, come on, when I stand before the great judge, I will feel a state of independence. Come on. I will feel, come on, can I get a witness? A feeling of freedom.
Yes.
Yes. Because I'll forever be a fool to the great God. Amen. Can I get a witness here? Amen. You understand that it doesn't make sense to go through a life of misery, a life of pain, a life of ups, and a life of downs.
That's right.
Come on. A life of turmoil, sometimes a life of torment, a time, sometimes when we feel burdened down,
great.
We feel that nobody cares.
Well, that's right.
Huh? Sometimes we feel like the weight of the world is on our shoulders. And then when we look for joy in this, or we look for joy in that, sometimes we can't find joy.
That's right, Pastor.
But I know that if I contend for the faith,
come on.
If I trust in his name, if I keep my hand in the master's hand,
yeah.
If I do what he said, if I do what he commands,
amen.
Yeah. We've done the will of God.
Amen.
We might, come on, Receive the promise. Somebody, right. Why is it written like that? Because sometimes we do so good for so long.
That's right.
And at the end, come on.
Go ahead. Yeah.
We give up.
That's right.
Amen. We throw in the towel. Come on in.
That's right.
Amen. When we begin to save in the temple life,
yes,
we begin to save our money. Y'all ain't hear me. We begin to put money in our 401k bank. Can I get away? But
right.
When it's not the power of the thing, come on. Okay. We set a goal in our life. So I'm going to put enough in when I retire. I'm going to have $150,000 in my 401. Come on.
That's right.
We began to put money in. Huh?
Amen.
But right before we get to $150,000, something happened.
That's right.
And we began to withdraw. Come on.
When
we withdraw, there are penalties.
Oh, yeah.
Can't get no help.
That's right.
For early withdrawal.
Oh, yeah.
It's the same in the spirit. When we start with God, we've got to have in our mind to go all the way.
Oh, yeah.
Because when we come back and fall back on God, there's penalty.
Amen.
There are times of disappointment. There are times of remembering when I used to go to church, I used to have joy, but now I can't feel no joy. So I sit on my seat Sunday after Sunday, amen, and I wash in my disappointment. I bathe in my heart. Pray God I usher in more of my prayer. So I'm paying. Come on, man. I'm paying. Can't get no help. I got to pay down because I gave up. Because I turned loose too soon. Amen. Don't you know that you turned loose too soon?
Amen.
That's why the Bible tells us they that run in a race, run on.
Amen.
Paul said, I don't run as one that is uncertain about the race I run.
That's right.
So I fight on.
Amen.
Some do it to obtain a corruptible crown.
Brave.
But we pace ourselves.
That's right.
Come on. Amen. That's why I said it's not good all the time to have testimony service.
Amen.
Brave.
Because sometimes, Sister Finn, we testify ahead.
Oh, yeah.
Can't get no help.
That's right.
We testify ahead. Can you get over there?
Yeah.
Jesus, in his own emphatic way, would do a good thing for somebody.
That's right,
sir. And Jesus would say, see thou, tell no man.
That's right. Amen.
That's right. He would say now, somebody, why does the scripture say that? Why does Jesus, amen, when he blessed people, sometimes he said, hold your peace.
That's right.
Some things that he done, the Bible says he charged them.
Amen.
To tell no man.
Matthew 16:20.
Listen at the book.
He charged his disciples that he should tell no man that he was Jesus the Christ.
See, sometimes what God does is for you. Can I preach? Sometimes what God shows you is for you. It's for me to build myself.
Yes, that's right.
It's for me to know, I'll assure you, that God is with me.
Yeah.
Come on. I can't get no help. Can I preach help? Amen. Sometimes God wants to bless me, I say. Can I get a ring? Amen. Ain't that right? Amen. But if I hold my peace, one time the bishop would tell us, amen, when God speaks to us, he would say, hold it. If and then he was, if you can.
Oh, yeah.
That's right.
Because sometimes God wants to work miraculously in my life. Can I preach? Sometimes he wants me, come on here, later. Praise God, amen. To be lifted by the power that he put in me.
That's right.
Can I preach?
Amen.
Amen. right. God, when God
come on here,
yeah, right. begin to work in your life.
That's right. Thank you, Jesus.
He's building you for the future.
Thank you.
Can I preach? Can I preach that? Yes. For the Bible says, while God is building on us, he may strive here.
Amen.
So in the end, that's a narrow gate.
Amen.
Oh, yeah, right. Can I preach here?
Yes, 13:24.
I feel like preaching now.
Amen.
Anybody here?
Amen.
You know that God is working on you?
Amen.
If you know that God is working on you, tap your head. Sometimes we work on things in our yard. We may not have the opportunity to buy everything at the same time.
That's right,
right. Sometimes we run the loads 4 times a week. Can't get no help.
That's right.
I'm the only one going in.
For
I love Lowe's. Honor, but some to honor, come on here.
Amen.
Some to dishonor.
Amen.
If a man continue working on himself,
Amen.
He will be a vessel of honor. Can I preach?
Yes, sir.
But day by day, we got to keep on marching. Come on. We got to be happy.
Amen.
Knowing that today I only nailed one piece of wood.
Amen.
But God is working on me.
Yes.
May I preach?
Yes.
I may have the same testimony that I had yesterday,
Amen.
But yesterday is gone.
Amen.
Come on here.
Yeah.
May I preach it?
Amen.
Amen. So I know I'm not where I used to be.
Yes, right.
See what I mean?
Yeah.
You got to look at life as stepping stone.
That's right.
Come on here. We don't have to pose everything
that
God does. But whatever God does for us is for our good.
Amen.
Come on here. Amen. May I preach?
Yeah.
I want you to believe that whatever God has done for you is for your good.
Amen.
Now somebody said, some bad things have happened in my life.
Oh yeah.
It's according to how you look at it.
That's right.
Something happened bad, so you can see your shortcomings.
Amen.
Come on. Something that happened makes us strong, but we take it that way.
Well, that's right.
When bad things happen, we can take it negatively, and they can kill us.
Oh, yeah.
Come on.
That's right.
And then when bad things happen, we turn to the Word of God, and we see in the Word of God that bad things happen to people in the Bible.
That's right.
Yeah, preach. Bad things happen in the Bible. The Bible says to men, pray.
That's right.
Come on. When Paul and Silas was in the Roman jail, come on here.
I can't get real fine.
Yeah. Yeah. That's right. Amen.
That's right.
They were in the Roman jail.
Yes, sir.
Bound. Come on.
Amen.
Between soldiers.
Amen. Yeah.
Come on.
That's right.
They were in a bad place.
Yeah.
Acts 16.
Amen. We'll begin at the 22nd verse.
Read it for me.
Multitude ruling together against them.
Listen at the book here.
And the magistrates rent off their clothes.
Uh-huh.
And commanded them to beat them.
Uh-huh.
And when they had laid many stripes upon them.
Follow me in the Bible.
Amen. They cast them into prison.
They cast them into Shoney.
They cast them into prison.
They cast them into Logan's Stig House.
Cast them into prison. That's right.
The book says they cast them into prison.
Charging the jailer to keep them safe.
Read the book, Zach.
Who?
Uh-huh.
Having received such a charge,
uh-huh.
Press them into the inner prison.
Put them way in the back.
Amen. And made their feet fast in the stocks.
Listen at the book here. And at midnight,
And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed.
At midnight, they come out.
And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed.
At midnight, they complained.
And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed.
After they gave up,
Paul and Silas prayed. And sing praises unto God.
No, they did not.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Yes, sir. And sing praises unto God.
That's right. See, the Word can make us happy,
yeah.
Or it can make us sad.
That's right.
The Word of God can find us.
Oh, yes,
y'all ain't the Word of God is the best flashlight there is.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
it.
It'll see you in the dark. It'll bring you out. But you got to keep the word near you. Can I preach?
They were in a secured prison. Huh?
Amen.
Where they could not get out. Amen. They had gotten whipped for preaching the word of God.
That's right.
They had gotten whipped for doing good things.
Yeah.
They have gotten whipped for doing no wrong at all.
That's right.
Come on here. You understand?
Yeah.
In this life, you're going to get whipping. Uh-oh.
That's right.
For doing good things.
Oh, yeah.
People don't talk about you.
Yes, sir.
When you try your best to live righteously.
Come on.
You're going to be a false accused. Come on here. You're going to be misused. Come on. May I preach?
Yes,
sir. Amen. For doing nothing at all. But you've got to know, amen, that God is for me.
Amen.
May I preach?
Amen.
You got to know that what I'm doing is for the glory of God.
Amen.
So, the book says,
and at midnight, all the silence breaks.
And we understand that midnight can be the darkest hour in one's life.
That's right.
When everything that can happen to you has happened.
That's right.
There ain't nothing else
that's right.
that can happen.
Amen.
Anybody ever felt like that?
Oh, yeah.
Anybody ever felt like, Brother Dale, that ain't nothing else can happen now? Because the worst of the worst has happened to me.
That's right.
Come on here. Anybody ever felt that I've been, we sang a song, I've been in a storm too long.
That's right.
So there ain't nothing else can happen now. So midnight, when the worst of the worst was upon the apostle.
Paul and Silas prayed.
Bible said both of them.
That's right. Amen.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Sometimes the situation, Brother Ellis, gets so hard that you and your wife need to go in prayer.
Amen.
Come over here.
That's right.
May I preach?
Yeah.
May I preach here?
Yes. Go ahead, Pastor.
Sometimes your partner needs to pray with you.
That's right.
And you need to be of one mind.
Amen.
So the Bible says Paul and Silas was in trouble together.
Amen.
And the book said, at midnight they prayed.
And sang praises unto God.
And they sang with joy.
Amen.
Praises is joyful events.
That's right.
Praise, come on here. Amen. Is a time of jubilee. Praise, amen, may I preach, is a triumph over my trouble.
Amen.
Can I get away with it? When I praise God, amen, I praise Him from my heart.
That's right.
For the things which He have done. For somebody He ain't done them yet. I praise Him in advance.
That's right.
Because God deserves jubilant praise.
Huh?
Let's not get it all twisted. And we said, when I get through this, I'm going to pray. No. We need to be a people of faith when we look over our circumstance.
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
Because if you look at your circumstance, you look at your trouble all the time, you ain't going nowhere.
Wouldn't
you? If I get out in the morning and my grass is 3 feet or 2 feet tall, and I look at it, it's going to be a hard day.
Oh, yes.
Because when the devil gets me to look at the grass, he's going to let the sun make me feel.
That's right.
He will speak to my mind.
Yeah.
And he will say, it's hard.
That's right.
Yes.
The devil will say, you ain't got no help. And the more you look at it, the weaker you're going to get.
Right now.
Can I preach?
Go ahead.
May I preach it?
Yes.
Amen. 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 Before I look at it, it's going to get wrecked. It's going to be a bad day.
Amen.
Come on, amen. I'll preach it.
That's right.
The
same with the troubles of our life.
Yeah.
When we look at the situation we're in, and we look at it, and we keep looking at it, we're going to stay right there.
That's right.
In our own situation. Yeah. But the Bible tells us, yeah, we got to be like Paul and Silas.
Yeah. Yeah. What
if they had midnight, Paul and Silas prayed? They praises unto God.
And the prisoners heard it.
And
that's right.
Yeah, that's
amen.
That's
right.
Yes,
if we say praises,
yes, sir,
unto God, mm-hmm, the devil, come on here.
Go ahead.
Yes. Nah, come on.
That's right.
That's causing us, come on here, to feel the sin.
Amen.
May I preach? Sin, the Lucifer, the son of the morning.
That's right.
You don't like me calling him that.
That's right.
When he hear, amen, that's right.
Right.
Come on now that he got his hooks in us. Mm-hmm. Huh? He need to hear, amen, that we are praying to God our Savior.
That's right.
Tell him, amen, amen, that's right. And now when I'm praying to him, I got joy. Come on.
Yeah.
While I'm praying to him,
amen,
he's going in trouble.
Right.
I still got joy.
Yeah.
May I preach? We, some people will say they're Christian, they are not no Christian.
Come on, man.
Because they don't believe.
Yes.
That's right.
When you are a Christian, you believe.
That's right.
In spite of,
yeah,
you believe,
yeah,
come on, regardless of, you believe, no matter how low you are,
yeah,
you believe,
yeah,
that God is for me,
right,
that God, come on,
yeah,
is to me what I need to believe.
At midnight, Paul and Silas prayed.
I can help somebody.
And sang praises unto God.
Sang praises unto God.
And the prisoners heard them.
And the trouble that they were in.
Come
here.
Amen.
Amen. That's right.
Got the attention of the praises.
Oh, yeah.
Come on here.
Amen.
Uh-huh.
And suddenly,
and the Bible tells us, when we do things as the Bible instructs us.
Amen.
Suddenly,
there was a great earthquake. So that the foundations of the prison were shaken.
Don't you tell me that if I do what the Bible tells me,
yeah,
that God will come to my refuge.
Well, yeah.
Don't you tell me, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, on Independence Day,
yeah,
that he who the Son set free, come on, and still bound, if the Lord deliver, praise God, my head and thought about you. You say, God deliver today.
Yeah.
Come on, may I breathe. Amen, yeah, God breathe. If God be in me,
thank
God in them, right? The Bible says the body is dead, and the God is sick, and the spirit is life.
Amen.
Amen. The spirit is life. Come on.
We
call the righteous.
Right.
May I preach it? Can I get a witness here? Sometimes in this life you will shout something.
Yes, sir.
That's right. The boys on the Indiana 500, them cars come through. Mm. When they come through there, everybody praying God.
Yes, sir.
Hollering and screaming.
Mm.
Come on here when they.
That's right.
When they win the race, you see that flag.
Yes.
You didn't see no sad people.
What?
But the one who lost.
That's right.
But the one who was set free.
Yes.
Amen. Sometimes they took the man out of the car. They had to go and get him out of there.
Yes, sir. That's right.
Come on here. And told him and give him his big chrome trophy.
Mm-hmm.
You know why?
That's right.
Because he held fast.
That's right.
He kept going till he went, till he won. Mm-hmm. Can you witness?
Yeah, right.
God is not going to let him in heaven unless we do what he says. God is not going to do well unless we done with.
Suddenly, there was a great earthquake.
Uh-huh.
So that the foundations of the prison were shaken.
Listen at the book.
And immediately,
uh-huh,
all the doors were open.
All the doors remained shut.
All the doors were open.
Uh-huh.
And everyone's bands were loose. That's right.
God worked in your life.
Yeah.
Your life will cause other folks.
That's right.
I can't get no help.
Yeah.
your life and what God does for you will call or draw the attention, come on,
right,
of hope.
Yes.
May I preach for God to get a shine in your life. Yeah. Amen. He shines bright enough that other folks will see the light in your life. When God free you, don't you know that God free other people through you? Don't you know when you hold on, your life will cause other people to hold on? Don't you know that when I look sad, Sister Kale, I cause other folk to look sad?
Amen.
Don't you know, being Earl, when I give up, somebody know that I gave up.
Yes, sir.
And it will call somebody else that will be looking at your life.
Well, that's right.
Come on. Because you know we have a lot of people looking at folk and not saying anything.
That's right.
Come on.
Yes, sir.
If a supervisor going to the workplace in the morning super droopy, it causes somebody
right
there to feel super droopy.
That's right.
Come on.
That's right.
But if you come to work spunky and chipper, come on,
that's
and
right
joyful,
yeah,
and hum a song at the coffee machine, somebody gonna be lifted.
That's right.
They may not tell you, but they gonna feel some jubilancy.
Oh yeah.
In their atmosphere.
Ready to pray.
You are the one that makes your day.
That's right.
May I preach? You are the one, come on, yeah, that man that is responsible for bringing joy into the lives of other folks. May I preach? May I preach? That man, the Bible said everybody bad was loose.
That's right. And the keepers of the prison are waiting out of this.
And the keepers of the prison.
That's right. Waking out of their sleep.
Waking out of their sleep.
And seeing the prison doors open.
What they done?
Threw out his sword.
Uh-huh.
And would have killed himself.
He would have.
Supposing that the prisoners had been fled.
Right.
But Paul cried with a loud voice, saying,
uh-huh,
thyself no harm.
Now when God save you, when God blesses you,
come on,
when God, praise God, pour out his spirit on you. You are going to try your best to encourage somebody else.
Oh, yeah.
So even though the guards were the keepers of the prisoners and would have done harm, further harm to himself, Paul encouraged him to do himself no harm.
We are all here.
In other words, we're in this together.
That's right.
I got to know that you need Jesus, you need Jesus, I need Jesus,
that's right,
we need Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
I got to know that you need saving, I need saving, they need saving, everybody needs saving.
That's right.
I got to know that Jesus is my Savior, he's your Savior, he's our Savior.
Amen. Right.
Come on.
Amen.
And together, we can triumph over our circumstance.
Amen.
But we need one another help.
That's right.
May we preach it.
Yes.
We need to be able, when we speak the word, to have somebody go no further in their disappointment.
Amen.
No further in their heartache.
Amen.
No further in their discouragement.
Amen.
Come on. And sometimes the testimonies are for the next person. Might not be for the whole church.
That's right.
But there may be a time or a point in our life when I can be talking to Mr. Norm. And then the Norm begin to tell me about his pitfall. And then I can say, Mr. Norm, in 1978, the same thing happened to me.
Well, that's right.
He will be surprised.
Oh, yeah.
Because 1978 was a long
time
ago.
Amen.
But whatever God does is forever.
That's right.
Come on. If it's God.
Amen.
So if God did it in 1978, you might can't tell it to 2021.
That's right.
but it's got to be for the glory of God.
Amen.
Come on. It can't be about me. It's got to be about God.
That's right.
Can I preach?
When God does things for people, he does it for his glory.
That's right.
May I preach? It is not for me to bestow any goodness on myself.
Yeah.
Come on.
That's right.
But to look at God as a merciful God, come on, a prayer answering God, because I was a prayer warrior. Now, we can't get to God unless we are prayer warriors. You understand?
That's right.
Let me preach it.
Oh, yeah.
The Bible says men ought to always pray and not to give up, not to faint. Come on here.
Right.
And if we've been praying, the Bible says, don't be weary in well doing.
Right.
For in due season, we will reap it. Can't get no help.
Paul called the lion's voice.
Listen to that God.
Saying,
what is that?
Do not step no harm. Amen. We are all here. And he called for a light.
He called for a light.
Let's bring in.
He didn't have no electric light back then.
That's right.
He had to have candles and lamps.
Amen.
But the Bible said he called for a light.
And sprang in.
And he ran in.
And came spring. And trembling. Amen. And fell down before Paul and Silas.
He fell down before Paul and Silas.
And brought them up.
Read.
And said, sir, what must I do to be saved?
Come on.
And they said,
what they say?
Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ,
yes,
and thou shalt be saved and thy house.
You have to be able to get to a point in your life that you draw somebody through your life,
come on, right,
through what God has done, through what God is doing,
amen,
through what God is doing. Can I preach? You gotta believe that God, praise God. I was telling my mom yesterday, I called her real briefly. I said, you know, you got a son with a birthday card.
Where's that?
I said, I'll be 57. She said, when were you 56?
Where's that?
See, time waits on no one.
That's right.
That's right.
Every year, you're going to get older.
Oh, yeah,
I preach.
Oh, yeah.
And with every time you get another year old, you need to become wiser.
That's right.
And I preach.
Oh, yeah.
And you praise God.
Praise God.
Tell you what. Amen. You need to be more of a witness than for Jesus this year than you was yesteryear. May I preach it? And when you get old, you're going to look run down.
That's right.
I can't get on here.
That's right.
So if I practice being super true, happy.
Go ahead.
I practice being sad all the time.
That's right.
I complain 100% of the day.
Oh, that much. That's right.
Great.
That's going to be my life.
That's right.
And in.
That's right.
Come on.
That's right.
I'm going to help
us.
But if I'm joyful, most of the time, because sometimes you have to worry
about
it. But most of the time, I'm jubilant to
the
past.
Yes,
sometimes, praise God, that man, I have trouble on top of trouble.
Yes.
But I flap my wings anyhow.
That's right.
You got to learn to live like that. You got to learn to live like you're already tired. You got to believe that today, praise God, that means tomorrow's going to be better every day. I got to believe that I'm awakening this morning. I'm going to get God to pray. I got to ask God to take me through the day. I got to believe that God's going to be with me all day.
Amen. That's good. That's up. Go ahead.
When I pray, I ask God to help me persevere.
That's right.
All day.
All day.
Now, when I go to God, I know the devil will start.
That's right.
From that point.
That's right.
Because he's trying to defeat me.
That's
because
right.
I have an appointment. An appointment.
That's right.
The appointment is the devil.
That's right.
And when I utter words, come on, the devil hears me when I call.
Oh, yeah.
Can I preach?
That's
so
right.
Sometimes in my mind, I need to speak to God, come on.
That's right.
In an unknown tongue. Uh-oh.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. When I speak to God, an unknown tongue, I'm talking directly to God. The devil is leading, and I'm talking to God. You understand this? So praise God. When I pray, I need to wait on the Spirit to talk to me, and I pray to God in the Spirit, and I pray to in an unknown tongue, because the enemy is pressing me. So now I need to talk directly to God.
Right.
So I pray to God in an unknown tongue. So God understands. And when I don't understand, the Spirit in me, praise God, God understands. God is the one that has control of my body. My spirit praying. I may not understand, but at that time I'm triumphant because I'm speaking directly to the master who sees in secret, who understands my way about. Come on. The Bible tells us things that are in the flesh, mind the things of the flesh. We need to pray that God give us the spirit of unknown tongues that we can pray.
Fight this preacher, fight that preacher, fight this church,
come on.
Fight this preacher, fight this sister, fight this brother.
No,
right.
And nobody
that's right.
is saying praises to God.
That's right.
Nobody
Amen.
Is hearing from God.
That's right.
Nobody is spiritual enough to help somebody
right.
praise God. Our attitudes, come on here, are becoming disoriented.
That's right.
Come on, deteriorating.
Oh, yeah.
We're becoming weak. The Holy Ghost ain't got no power. They don't have no anointing. I said, Lord. And we purchase it and we put it on And we said we feel all right.
But in every nation.
But the book says so. In every nation,
he that feareth him and worketh righteousness is accepted with him.
Is disqualified.
Is accepted with him.
Got to be true holiness.
Is he that worketh, that feareth him and worketh righteousness.
Got to be named true holiness.
He that feareth him and worketh righteousness is accepted.
What makes the church of God and the church of God and true holiness in the people?
Yes,
sir. That's God and God into the chapter and the verses. The fear of God is the beginning of wisdom.
Amen.
Y'all understand
this? Amen.
People that call themselves church of God is walking around with cases of death.
That's right.
And calling good evil and evil good. Put life for darkness and darkness for life.
Yes, sir.
And I preach. For more than one thing, stand still.
Stand still. Yeah. Go ahead.
Y'all gonna get me off course. I said the people
that
say they are charitable are putting life for darkness and darkness for life.
Yes.
Because they deeds are evil.
Yes.
Right?
That's right. That's right. Amen.
Now,
that's right.
The Bible said, whom the Son has set free is free indeed.
Yes.
And you shall know the truth, and the truth, come on, shall make you free. Can I preach?
Yes.
So, you mess it up.
Yes.
Mess it all up.
That's right.
Come on.
Amen.
When you mess it up, Revelation says you lost your first love.
That's right.
That's what the book says.
Amen.
That's right. Huh? The book says, be joyous and repent.
Yeah.
Come on. May I? That's
right.
Huh?
Yeah.
That means you were way up the road with Christ.
Yeah.
But you backed up.
That's right.
And the Bible says, strive to eat.
Yeah,
come on here. When we got down where the devil was giving us all kind of minds.
Yes, sir.
Come on, because the devil is a man of many, many minds.
That's right.
Come on here.
Yeah.
When he began to give us many minds, amen, we began to point at this person and point at that person and say, who is holier than this person?
That's right.
So what happened? It gave holiness a bad name. Give me Isaiah 64, and I believe 64. It gave it a bad name. Come on.
Amen.
Religious folk began to get a bad name.
Yeah.
Right. Come on. Because they began to start walking, amen, not circumspectly, but started walking as what? Fool.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, dear.
Man.
Look what he said.
Yeah.
Come on, son. Y'all preach out.
Go ahead, man.
64, I believe.
64, what are you looking
for? Isaiah.
That's not
64, and verse 4. Verse 4, what do you say?
For since the beginning of the world,
uh-huh,
men have not heard nor perceived by the ear, neither have the eyes seen,
uh-huh,
O God,
read
beside thee what he prepared for, what he hath prepared for him that waited for him.
Read that.
Thou meetest him,
uh-huh,
that rejoices, and what is righteousness? Those that remember thee in thy ways,
behold,
thy wrath. For we have sinned, and those is conscience. And we shall be saved.
Uh-huh.
But we are all as an unclean thing.
We all as what an unclean thing.
And all our righteousness are as filthy rags.
Yes.
And we all do fade as the leaf.
Uh-huh.
And our iniquities, like the wind, have taken us away.
Our iniquities.
Amen.
Right here. Iniquities ain't nothing but all that we can't pray in tongues.
That's right.
Amen.
And there is none.
And there is none.
That calls upon thy name.
That's what's going to finally happen.
That's right.
Amen.
That's what's going to finally happen. There will be nobody in the church.
That's right.
That calls on the name of God.
That's right.
And get delivered.
That's right.
You understand?
That's right.
Hmm? Because at this time, don't bother me, and I won't bother you. Come on here.
That's right.
Huh? Don't look down on me because of my People want to feed.
That's right.
That's right.
People want to feel. People want to come up short. Amen? Yeah. What are you looking at me for?
That's right.
Why are you worrying about me? Mm-hmm. Huh? Yeah. Look at the orange hair. Mm-hmm. So what do? They fight, and they fight, and they fight.
Yes. Oh, yeah.
I come on here. And all our unrighteous will become filthy rags.
That's right.
Come on here. Yeah. Amen. Our iniquities will be just like the wind. Amen. All over the place.
And there's none that call upon thy name.
Then there'll be none that call upon thy name.
The spirit of himself to take hold of thee.
Uh-huh.
For thou hast hid thy face from us.
Because the Lord will be so ashamed. Yes, come on here. He'll be so ashamed that he'll hide his face from us.
And has consumed us.
Uh-huh.
Because of our iniquities.
Because of our sins. Ain't that
right?
Right?
That's right.
Come on, son.
But now, O Lord.
But now, O Lord.
Thou art our Father.
Uh-huh.
We are the clay.
Come on, son.
And thou art our part.
Right.
And we are all, we are on the work.
So what's got to happen, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, we got to get back. Come on here. So we first believe God. Come on.
Amen.
And we got to know that God is our Father, and we are the clay. Praise God.
Right.
And we know that God
got
to make us into what is
worthy.
That's right.
We got to be.
That's right.
We got to
preach
here. Amen. Amen. We got to come on in.
Bring it.
Amen. And that's right. But we can't walk between two opinions. If God be God, follow God.
That's right. That's right.
For God is a spirit. And they that worship God can worship God in iniquity.
That's right.
That's right.
They do it.
What I wear, a wig. Come on. As a man, for no cause, but to make myself handsome. I'm lusting in the pride of life.
That's right.
What is not of the Father, but I'm full of pride.
That's right.
When I beautify myself outside of God, and when the people of the church praise God and put more glory on my hair.
That's right.
Uh-oh.
That's right.
On
oh,
what I have on.
Oh, yeah.
That's right. Agree.
Amen.
My fingernails. That is what.
Come on.
I'm practicing falsehood.
That's right.
That's right.
Amen.
Bible tell us in Romans chapter 12, I beseech you, therefore, brethren,
right,
by the mercies of God,
amen,
that you present your body,
amen,
a living sacrifice. Some of the machines, I don't get to work because I got workers.
That's right.
That work on.
Right.
And if they go on vacation, I have to use. Well, that's what I'm doing today.
Amen.
Sometimes the word I don't have to use.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm going to use it today now.
Right. Yes, sir.
And that means I need to know how to use.
Yes. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. I'm not here. People try to take the word of God from the devil.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. They try to say that the Old Testament was blah, blah, blah. And the New Testament is blah, blah, blah. But Romans chapter 12 and verse 1 say, I was seeking to have more brother. Because God is merciful.
That's right.
No matter for how long, if God would just take charge right there.
Mm-hmm.
Say, well, I'll tell you what, I'm getting brother Elvis 3 times. Third time, I'll wipe them off.
My Lord.
Wouldn't be nothing nobody can say.
No, that's right.
So when we go to work as one image, and we go to church as another image.
That's right.
That's right.
And the Bible tells us every morning when we get up, see, I don't understand the word here.
Really?
That's right.
It's not only in the church that we're supposed to present our body.
That's right.
But it's every day that you're supposed to present your body.
Yes.
A living sacrifice.
Yes.
A sacrifice that is holy.
Amen.
That's right. and tell God I'm sorry.
That's right.
When we get on our job, we do all kinds of things.
Yes, sir.
That's right. Amen.
Say all kinds of things.
Oh, yeah.
And, that's right. Go ahead, preach.
That's right, Pastor.
He didn't say, read Romans 12 and verse 1. Read them slow for me now. I need it for me. Come on, sir.
I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice.
A living sacrifice at church only.
A living sacrifice. Holy. Acceptable unto God.
Only at church.
A living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God.
Well, ain't God a 24-7?
Yes, sir. Which is a reasonable service.
A God go on vacation?
Yes, sir.
I said he went. Yeah, he did. He went on vacation 7 days. Well, when I wake up in the morning.
Amen, that's right.
Listen at me, ladies and gentlemen. Right. Brothers and sisters.
Yeah.
When I wake up in the morning, I look and I see that I'm alive.
Yeah.
I said, thank you, God.
Right.
For being alive today.
Right.
Give me life, health, and strength to do your will.
Amen.
And put on a pair of pants.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Better be glad God ain't like me.
Yeah.
Those of you that smoking funny cigarettes.
That's right. That's right. That's right. Yep. Amen. That's right.
Come on. Amen. I just smoking the funny cigarettes.
Yeah.
Drinking booze.
Amen.
Here's the question. Are we presenting our body a living sacrifice?
That's right.
Holy, acceptable unto God, within your reasonable service.
Amen. Yes, sir.
And what else the book say?
And do not conform to this world.
I'm getting ready to come in now.
But be transformed.
Be not conformed to the world.
That's right.
But be ye
transformed by the renewing of your mind.
So that means, when we were preached doctrine in the back days, the doctrine we were preached, a doctrine ain't nothing but a teaching.
That's right.
Come on here.
That's right.
A guide to live by. That's what a doctrine is.
That's right. Right.
Amen. It's a teaching. Yes. Somebody said, well, no, it ain't. That's a cult. No, it ain't either. Chapter and verse.
That's right.
Are doctrines. Come on here.
That's right.
To live by.
Amen.
And be guided by.
Oh, yeah.
So when you get the doctrine in your heart.
Amen.
Uh-oh.
Amen. Amen.
Paul, so you don't have no need for the teacher.
That's right.
Because the teacher is in you.
That's right.
That's right. That's right.
So all the preacher does is stir up your pure mind.
That's right.
But why your mind can't be stirred up? Because your mind is not pure anymore.
That's right.
Amen. Your mind is worldly.
Yeah.
And if we stay worldly, our mind will become hypocritical.
Oh, yeah. Right.
Can't get no help.
Yeah. That's right. Boy, yeah.
That's right. Boy, yeah. And we're falling on belief.
Right.
May I preach? Can I say it?
Amen.
Like it is.
Yeah.
And we won't be saved because we didn't believe chapter and verse.
That's right.
Amen.
Can I preach?
Yes, sir.
Now, ain't that right?
Yeah.
Can I get away? So we about through now. Ain't that right? But we thank God, amen. We got off today a little bit there, but we saved with chapter and verse.
That's right.
Amen.
2 Corinthians 7 and verse 1.
Look at that 2 Corinthians chapter 7 and verse 1.
I mean, not for these promises, dearly beloved.
Understand God.
Let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of God.
That's right. The Bible says we already have been given the great and the precious promise.
That's right.
Wherefore, what do you say?
And therefore,
these promises,
dearly beloved, let us cleanse ourselves.
Don't look at the next man.
That's right. That's right.
Got to stop. That's one thing the Holy Spirit got to stop doing.
That's right.
Looking at the next man.
That's right.
Let the preacher preach and let the teacher teach. Come on.
Yeah. All filthiness of the
flesh. But we have to do this. The preacher got to, well, come on.
That's right. Yeah. And spirit. Right.
Preacher got to keep up there.
Yeah. Right.
You find yourself in, you got to get back on the furry line like you're going to say.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Right, come on here.
Yes, sir.
Cleanse the next man.
Ourselves.
Yeah. That's right.
From what?
From all filthiness of the flesh.
From all filthiness of the flesh.
And spirit.
Uh-oh. The spirit can't go bad.
That's right.
So the spirit, I had some good tomatoes this week.
All right.
They were so good. I had three red. I didn't want them to spoil. So I take it upon myself, it's funny now, and I ate all three of them. I put five.
Yeah. That's all right.
Pretty nice five.
Yeah.
You know why? Because I didn't want to come on and it was four like I did last year.
That's right.
Right. Sometimes people say, I ain't got a taste for it. Well, you better make yourself.
That's right.
Have a taste for something.
Yeah, right.
I didn't have a taste for it either, but when I bite into it,
yes, sir.
Man,
it
I ain't stuck. I got on three of them. The same with our seven.
That's right.
Why don't they cleanse yourself from all dirty of the flesh and dirty of the spirit from making it holy night
in the service of
sometimes, praise God, you don't want to do it. But you have to do it.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So you won't fall.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's right.
If I had waited until I had a taste for it, guess what? I probably had to throw it away.
That's right. That's right.
But since I didn't have a taste and I did it anyhow, then the taste came back.
Yeah.
When you live holy, when you practice living holy, you will get a taste for it.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Huh?
That's right.
You hear me?
Yeah.
Amen. If it looks like you might not need you. Amen. But if you know that you got to go on to need God, you will do it.
That's right.
So I
ate
all three of them.
That's right.
And it was good for the belly.
That's right.
Huh? Don't want to live holy. It's boring. You're not getting, praise God, recognized by your peers. We love our peers.
That's right.
So we do things according to the book, and our spirit man fails.
That's right.
That's right. Amen.
But if we put faith only in the faith of God, guess what's going to happen? We'll wrong no man.
That's right.
Somebody, what that mean? You won't call somebody, look at you, and say, what the world happens to you? Yeah.
That's right.
He shouldn't have to wonder about you.
That's right.
Amen.
So you're wronging him for having to wonder about you.
That's right.
And you're cutting up so bad. Ain't that right?
That's right.
Come on here.
Save us.
Save us.
Receive us.
Receive us.
We have wronged no man.
Uh-huh.
We have corrupted no man.
Uh-huh.
We have defrauded no man.
Uh-huh.
That's right. I speak not this to condemn you.
So Paul said, now he was teaching. He wasn't trying to condemn him for. Because we all stand, amen. The Bible says, amen. We exhort ourselves, we shall be obeyed.
That's right.
Didn't he say so?
That's right.
Amen. Huh? Come on.
That's right. Okay.
But what? Paul said, I didn't do this to condemn you.
For I have said before.
What did he say?
That ye are in our hearts to die and live for you.
Ain't that right? So we, amen, we care about one another. We love one another. Amen. Ain't that right? We're going to keep praying for each other. Ain't that right? We're going to keep putting the word of God out there in case somebody wants to be saved.
That's right.
Ain't that right?
Amen.
So you pray for me, I'll certainly pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Yeah.